There you go.
Really good. Okay. So I had a growth of women's in hockey, and would you say if you like a star athlete in any sport or league, you say it's pretty hard to get in the Hall of Fame? Would you all agree? I guess. So, you're not going to see a lot of many female athletes in, Hockey Hall of Fame, and there's only one woman I know that's made it, and I actually went to Toronto 2 years ago and actually found her in Hockey Hall of Fame. As you see from the graph, that the number of girls playing youth hockey in the U.S. is interesting because of how much of it has progressed and gotten more noticeable for it. In 1991, only about 6,000 girls were registered to play in the U.S. for USA Hockey, and by 2016, over 75,000 girls were playing USA Hockey. This number did not include girls playing at high school or college level. In the 10 years after the first women's championship in 1990s, the number of girls playing hockey has grown over about 80%. Women's college hockey is growing. Most of the college hockey is mostly in the Northeast or North Dakota or Wisconsin area, but most likely it's in Northeast areas. It first started four teams in a tournament that played D1 women's, and now that has actually grown to 36 teams in four major conferences, and there are also six independent colleges that also play for D2 level, not D1, but it's D2. At the D3 level, there are almost 50 teams that play for women's hockey. Many schools also have clubs. So here at EKU, we have club hockey. And we don't have a women's team, but it'd be nice to have one, I guess. Most of these schools are very similar. Most of the schools were also located in Northeast, or Jerry said that. So this is a logo of National Women's Hockey League. Now this is kind of hard to explain, I guess. Now this is only in America. There are other teams in Canada that do play, but they're not one league. So for men's in Canada, they also play. There are also teams in Canada that play, but teams in America, but most teams are in America, but you get that. The first American pro women's league with paid players started in 2015 with four teams in America. I'm pretty sure one of those women was named Hillary Knight. She's one of the USA players and one of the first women to actually get paid to play in this sport. Most teams are either in the NWHL, will be in Buffalo, Boston, Minnesota, Connecticut, New York, areas around there. It's slowly growing. They're thinking about actually combining the Canadian teams with the American teams to make one bigger league. Three teams actually have NHL sponsors or partnerships, really. And the games are live streamed on Amazon, Twitter, and Facebook Live. Now, Amazon, Twitter, and Facebook, you're not really, popular, I guess, compared to like broadcast television channels like NBC, ESPN, or NBC, ABC, or whatever channels are on. So they don't really get that many like publicity, I guess, around everyone. Some games are also shown on local stations. So maybe like if you live in like, you know, like I said, areas like Boston, New York, Connecticut, or Minnesota, you know, you might get those, but probably not like, you know, like midday when it actually shows, because it's not that big right now. So it might be on like those like channels that in the middle of the night people will be like, have like no idea what the show is, because it's on at like 3 in the morning or something like that. There is also a, this is one of the women, her name is Cami Bernardo, I think I said that right. She also has a book that I probably should have brought, most likely, but she's the first woman introduced into the Hall of Fame in 2010 for hockey, and she made it this far despite not playing her last 2 years of high school because there were only boys teams. She played in college at Providence and won a silver medal at the first World Cup championship. She also was the captain for the U.S. Olympic team in 1998 and 2002. She won a gold and silver medal. She was offered an NHL tryout, which is pretty impressive, because usually you don't ever see a girl, you know, I guess most supporters or whatever, no offense, ladies, but get like an NHL tryout to play a men's sport. But she ended up like rejecting that. I mean, to me, I was kind of shocked, because you know, a lot of you like, you know, women actually playing in the men's sport, actually, you know, I mean, she actually made the roster and playing against these men, she does really good, you know, it's like, showing her that, you know, women aren't really weak. You know, they can play at the same level as men can. But instead, she became a broadcaster for hockey, and she overcame great odds to reach the Hall of Fame. But women's hockey grows. Maybe she won't be the only one that makes it to the Hall of Fame. Like Billy Knight, I said earlier, she probably might go to the Hall of Fame. She's a great athlete. I actually watched some of the women's hockey games, and you know, they're different compared to men's, but I mean, they're still fun to watch, and she's a great player. I mean, now with in Finland and Sweden, there's a couple more players that are, might get inducted because how athletic they are and how good their skills are as well. That's it.
Okay. Thank you. And Tyler, question.
This is really general. Like, is hockey your favorite sport? Is that what you did?
Yeah, it's my favorite.
Okay. Did I get everybody? If there anybody would like to give another speech here? Okay. I will see you. You notice that on your sheet, we won't, I'll see you on the 27th. When you do this, when you're here again, now there'll be a as well. So there'll be, it'll be a lot more people. Again, remember these, there's three things I want you to remember here. Story is intro, we talked about that. You need to cite your sources. And there may be some confusion. When you cite your sources, that's within your speech, okay? Not at the end of any text, okay? So you, as you're going speaking, say the words, that's where they're from. Don't depend on putting them up on the screen. You don't need to do that. And then the third thing is your ending. Make it impactful, as I say, impactful, meaningful, direct, definitely a good last statement. And really, the best way is to attach it back to your story at the beginning of it. That's a really good technique, good way to do it. Any questions by anybody? We'll see you after Thanksgiving. John, did you have notes?
Oh, yeah.
Incomes tonight. This is your first meeting.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Would you, just to attend. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Not to get speeches. Yeah. You know? You'll be here for A's group. Second speech. Yes. Yeah.
Thank you.
I misunderstood what you were saying. Okay. So you put in a band or anything other than EKU kinds of ensembles and stuff?
No, I haven't before.
Is that something you want to do, or is it just or are you?
I feel like if I was given the opportunity, I would.
Yeah. That'd be fun.
Yeah.
Okay.